Time for a teardown. Haven't done one of those in a while. And this is, as usual, something different. Box says Pad Pack 03, and it's got an expiry date of 2017, which is how I got my hands on a sealed device like this. Any guesses? Any guesses? Samaritan Smart Pad Pack Battery. Yes, this is the battery and electrodes replacement set or kit or whatever for a Samaritan brand automated external defibrillator. So what this has in it is a, what is it, LiMNO2 lithium magnesium oxide battery. And it also has the pads or electrodes that you stick to your victim. So this goes inside the bottom. Actually, let's just quickly go and take a peek at what this defibrillator unit looks like. Just so we know what we're talking about here. So here is what the defibrillator itself looks like. Looks like there's various different models of it. I can't remember which one exactly it was that this was a spare for. But there it is on the USFDA's website. There it is on the manufacturer's website. Again, not too much. Apparently you can get an add-on for these things to make them Wi-Fi linked and whatever. Well, I'm not entirely clear on the life-saving benefit of that. Maybe it's a reporting thing, I don't know. But anyway, here is essentially what I've got on my workbench right now. For $180, you get this. It's for Pad Pack, Heart Sign brand only. Always have a fully charged spare available. Sure, why not? It doesn't say all that much. Oh well. Let's just go and do our own investigation, shall we? So you'll find these units, these defibrillator units, in a lot of public places these days, and in a lot of offices and industrial environments. This came out of an office, out of the storage cabinet for an office underneath one that luckily has never been used, which is good. So what do we have on here? There's four contacts that go into the base unit, a couple of latch, clippy latch things, and some instructions on how to use it. So they're designed to be very simple to use. You push the button on the unit, you listen to the voice prompts, hopefully they're in your language. You stick the two pads on where it says, the voice prompt tells you, but also you just put one just on the upper right chest and one lower left chest just around the side. Then stand clear when it tells you. It analyzes the person's heart rhythm, and if it decides that they need an electric shock across the heart to restart it, or actually to interrupt it and try and get it back into a normal rhythm, then it will do that. And then it will continue monitoring and tell you to resume CPR until the voice prompt tells you to do something else. Presumably somewhere in step zero, you would have called 911. So anyways, so with this latched into the unit, to use it, you grab that and yoink it out, and there is the pads themselves, which are glued in. Holy hell. Single use only, yeah. But, okay, so there's one of the reasons why it's expired. Or do you just, oh, never mind. Just strip that apart. Okay. In an emergency situation. Fine. Okay. So here's the two pads. And they've got a kind of a gooey gel on there. On those, you know, rescue TV shows, you see them putting some gooey gel on their defibrillator pads to stick them on the person. Well, this is just a kind of an adhesive version. So you slap that one on there. Slap that one on there. And then these two report back, presumably through one of these, to the base unit and tell it what, or it analyzes the heart rhythm and tells it what to do next. So, since this is a one-use item and it is all sealed, gonna have to go in through this glued-in cover here, I'm thinking. Well, it's crunching. I've been learning from Big Clive's methods. Bits of violence are always good for getting into these things. Now then, because it's a lithium battery, I'm going to have to be a little bit careful because I don't want to stab into it. Because we've all been warned 100 times what happens if you poke a hole in a lithium battery. I'm expecting this to be one of those kind of pouch type battery packs. It's not. Wow. And even though this guy expired in 2017, take a look at that. The battery pack itself has a best before of July 2020. Woohoo, score! So, what else we got? What do we see here? So here's the two wires coming from the pads that go on the chest. And they go out through these two screws here, which is these two over here. They're marked A and S. I'm sure there's a good medical Latin meaning for those terms. I'm just a basic first aider. I don't know that kind of stuff. It's not important to me to know. And here is the battery, plus and minus. I could have measured that without yoinking this thing apart. Too bad. Going in. And those are glued in. Of course they are. But no, they're not. That's double-sided tape under there. Lithium battery. Do not charge. Do not short circuit. Do not puncture or deform. Do not incinerate. Dispose in accordance with local regulations. Ah, that is some fairly aggressive stuff. Okay, and these down in here, that looks like a Torx screw holding those on. They're crimped in and then just lugs into there. Okay, this is, we know this is designed as a one use system. No user serviceable parts inside. These cells are CR123, each one 3 volts. And like it said, they're not rechargeable. A little bit ginger going in here. They don't want to short circuit anything. That would be bad.
But the straps are on the end, so I'm probably not going to cut through anything going in besides there. Except for this one set of straps in there, I guess. Yes, I'm cutting towards my hands. This shrink sleeve they put on there. And it's pretty tenacious stuff, actually. But we're almost in. Looks like there's no...
It looks like there's no protection in here either. It's just one big series pack. Oh, it does look like there's a bit of protection in there. Looks like there's some kind of a little fuse in this little bit of heat shrink here. Let's see if I can get into it. Does that say 4 amp to you? I guess that's reasonable. So these cells will just charge up a big ass capacitor in the base unit. They won't drive the shock directly. There'll be a high voltage power supply in there and some kind of a boost circuit. So that 4 amps is just, if that's what that is, that's just recharging that, that high voltage supply in the main unit. So there is the voltage across the pack. We'd expect 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18 volts. And we're showing 19.6. So that is one fully charged pack. I suppose I could have tested that from outside, but whatever. So there we go. Not much to see inside it, really. All the smarts are in the main device, which in this case was still certified and hadn't expired, so I wonder if there's anything to see in these pads. There's, if I go in from this side, there's that goopy stuff that sticks to you. So I think I'm just gonna open this up. And okay, not much to see in there. Looks like it's just riveted on, and then this little adhesive-backed foamy pad so that nobody gets cut, because that would be bad. Yeah, let's just rivet it on there. I wonder if that gel stuff is actually conductive. So this is, I'll just put that on there. So I'm on the lowest impedance setting that I've got. Okay. So does it capacitively couple when it zaps you? Well, now I can't get in there. Come on. Let me in. There we go. So no, it's not directly conductive, so it just, it must just capacitively couple in or something. Are not quite as interesting as I'd intended. Like I said, the interesting stuff is obviously in the base station, not in here. Not sure what I'm going to do with those cells. What does it say on them? Warning, risk of fire, explosions, and burns. Do not recharge, crush, or heat above 212 Fahrenheit. 100 Celsius, so don't boil them. And then repeat it again in German and French and caliente hot. That's Spanish, I'm guessing, right? Oh, well, that was interesting. And before somebody asks, it's Fort Garry Dark. My old favorite for years gone by. And of course, what goes better than tearing apart medical equipment than having a beer? Well, thanks for joining me on this little adventure. You never know until you look inside, right? That's what curiosity is about. Well, thanks for watching. I will talk to you later.